An exhausted and seemingly despondent Donald Trump is closing out his campaign with rambling speeches to dwindling crowds, threatening violence, making baseless allegations of cheating, floating the possibility of banning vaccines, and complaining about Saturday Night Live. Is it that he misses me on Update? Oh, well then. If it's not that, then f*** him. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. None of us can control what happens tomorrow. We can only control how drunk we are when it happens. If you're like me, you've been searching desperately for at least some small indication of how things might go, but the polls have not been helping.
NBC's poll finds that the race remains deadlocked and unchanged, with both candidates tied at 49% each.
The latest CNN poll of polls shows things completely tied.
National polls have Harris and Trump locked in a dead heat.
The final NBC News national poll also finds the presidential race neck and neck.
If you just go through, the average of the poll shows dead heat. So either candidate could win all of these states.
The presidential race, a dead heat. And in those battleground states, as mentioned, the same. It's neck and neck, well within the poll's margin of error.
Every single battleground state is a coin toss.
No clear leader.
No clear leader. This is basically a tie, folks.
Yeah.
This is a toss-up election.
This election remains a toss-up.
Basically, this is a tied race.
How can so many polls be tied? Are they doing the first half of the poll at an artisanal coffee shop in Williamsburg and the second half of the poll in the beer line at a Kid Rock concert? What's taking so long? I want to get back for more Kid Rock! How is it possible that exactly half the country thinks Trump is an amoral psychopath who would wreck American democracy and the other half thinks he's an amoral psychopath who would wreck American democracy, but it's worth it because he's a really good dancer? If only someone had the courage to release an outlier poll that doesn't show the same exact thing as every other poll that's already out there.
We have a new poll releasing right this moment out of Iowa from the Des Moines Register, and you'll want to take a look at this one. In a head-to-head matchup, the Des Moines Register is showing Harris with 47 to Trump's 44 in the state of Iowa.
Holy the only thing more shocking than Harris winning Iowa would be Harris winning Mar-a-Lago and then Mar-a-Lago winning TripAdvisor's best place to host a wedding that won't be interrupted by a former president giving a long speech about Arnold Palmer having a horse. I have no idea if the Iowa poll is right or wrong, but it seems to have really rattled Trump, who complained about it all weekend.
The polls are just as corrupt as some of the writers back there. They can make those polls sing. They can make them sing. They brag about it. I got a poll, I'm 10 points up in Iowa. One of my enemies just puts out a poll, I'm 3 down. They just announced a fake poll. Hey, think of it, right before the election that I'm 3 points down. I'm not down in Iowa. The polls, I'm telling you, you can make those suckers sing. You get the right pollster, you can do, and you really do inflict damage, you know, when you do like this person from Iowa. Today, the election essentially is really, we're talking turkey, comes out with a poll. Different from every other poll. It's called suppression. They suppress, and it actually should be illegal.
All this guy does is whine. He sounds like someone slowly letting air out of a balloon. Also, why does he keep saying you can make the polls sing like he's a private eye from a 1950s radio play? You listen up, you dirty rat. You better give it to me straight because the next pollster who walks in that door is gonna make you sing. That's right, we're talking turkey now. So with the polls as tight as they've ever been in modern American history, both campaigns are going all out with their closing messages. Kamala Harris became the first candidate to advertise on the Sphere in Las Vegas. She made a surprise appearance on SNL, and her campaign aired this powerful new ad during NFL games on Sunday.
Throughout this campaign, I've seen the best of America, and I've seen what is holding you back and weighing you down. High costs, fundamental rights taken away, and politics that have driven fear and division. You deserve better. As president, I'll bring a new generation of leadership. I'll take on price gouging and bring down the cost of groceries and housing and prescriptions. I'll fight for your freedom to make your own choices, and I will protect your health care and your benefits, not take them away.
Look, I know it's just an ad, but it is refreshing to see something positive from a politician rather than yet another attack ad with ominous music about how roving gangs of transgender prisoners are coming with military-style weapons to occupy your suburban neighborhood, outlaw your hamburgers, and force you to drive a Prius with a bumper sticker that says science is real. But, you know, hey, but maybe you guys, maybe I'm not being fair. Maybe Trump has some soaring words for his supporters as well. Let's see his closing message. Oh, sorry. Oh, my God. Sorry. Oh, my God. I just had a flashback to trying to turn off Cinemax because I heard my parents coming down the stairs. Seriously, dude, if you did that during charades, you'd be banned from game nights. I don't care what the answer was. Oh, deep throat. It was okay. It was deep throat. And it was, you know what? It was actually a pretty good clue. I apologize. You know, you spend almost an entire decade trying to elevate the discourse and avoid easy anti-Trump jokes so you can focus instead on the grave consequences of Trump's deeply corrosive policy agenda that would irrevocably poison American democracy and cause mass suffering for millions of people. And then right at the finish line, he makes it impossible to avoid. The dude blows. That's just an accurate description of what he's doing, what he chose to do. Here's how bad that was. After the rally, Rudy tried to get the microphone to sign an NDA just out of habit. I'm gonna whisper so no one can hear us. What do you mean you amplify sound? Oh, Rudy! You did it again! This guy's rallies have been unhinged and bizarre, but in the closing weeks of the campaign, they've gone so far off the rails that even his supporters seem baffled, which might explain why he seems, at least, to be having trouble filling seats, like at his rally in Atlanta last week, where the crowd seemed very sparse, or this rally in North Carolina, where the entire upper section was blocked off and there were plenty of empty seats below. I mean, what gives? Do audiences not want to see a 78-year-old man simulate fellatio on a piece of audio equipment anymore? This isn't a My America anymore. People are over the traveling Trump show. They've seen it. Trump's even been trying to trot out old guest stars to liven things up, like werewolf and vampire enthusiast Herschel Walker, the guy who showed off a fake badge at a Senate debate 2 years ago. He introduced Trump at a rally in Georgia, and all he had to do at this rally, really, was tell people to vote for Donald Trump.
It stopped on Tuesday when we get to the polls and we vote for my friend and your friend, Donald Trump Jr. Donald Trump, Donald J. Trump.
I mean, just for safety, I feel like Walker should still wear his old helmet even during speeches. You can't get a concussion from talking. Oh, don't underestimate him. But don't worry, it's not like Trump is gonna put Walker in charge of, you know, anything important.
We will build a missile defense shield, all made in the USA, wrapped around our country to defend ourselves and our country. It's all gonna be made in the United States and a lot of it in your great state. We'll put Herschel Walker in charge of that little sucker, okay?
And when he heard that, Walker said, it would be an honor, Ronald McDonald Jr. I'm not sure what inspires less confidence, putting Walker in charge or referring to a highly complex missile defense system that would presumably involve the world's most advanced weaponry and communications technology is that little sucker. Like it's the gopher who's been eating his petunias. I'm gonna sit outside with a BB gun. I'm gonna get that little sucker. But Walker is not the only Trump-adjacent weirdo who's apparently been promised a key job in a second Trump administration. Trump has also decided to close out his campaign by promising that bear carcass collector and ye olde inn for brainworms, RFK Jr., will be making crucial decisions about your family's health if Trump wins.
Robert F. Kennedy Jr. said at a virtual Get Out the Vote event on Monday that he will be put in charge of the nation's major public health agencies should Donald Trump win the presidency.
President Trump, you said last night you would essentially let Robert F. Kennedy Jr. do whatever he wants with health care. What factual
he's going to have a big role in
health care.
You're comfortable with his views on vaccines, Mr. President?
We'll be talking about a lot of things, but he's going to have a big role in health care.
The key that I think that President Trump has promised me is control of the public health agencies, which are HHS and its sub-agencies, CDC, FDA, NIH, and a few others, and then also the USDA.
This is what RFK Jr. tweeted out yesterday. On January 20th, the Trump White House will advise all U.S. water systems to remove fluoride from public water.
I'm going to let him go wild on health. I'm going to let him go wild on the food. I'm going to let him go wild on medicines.
Generally speaking, no one who actually knows anything about medicine says the words, I'm gonna go wild on medicine. There's not a show called Doctors Gone Wild, although there should be. McSteamy, McDreamy, I haven't seen anything this pornographic since Trump went down on that mic earlier in this closer look. Trump's own advisors and Republican allies are reportedly baffled by this closing message, and I think even Trump can sense that the vibes are bad because he seemed pretty despondent at his rallies this weekend.
I'm trying to tell you what's happening with our country. It's going bad. And it can never get fixed because we're never going to get the right people in because of what they do with the elections. We're going to get a bunch of crooks and horrible people. And then they accuse you of being a conspiracy theorist. He's a conspiracy. And they want to lock you up. They want to put you in jail. The ones that should be locked up are the ones that cheat on these horrible elections that we go through in our country. We had the safest border in the history of our country the day that I left. I shouldn't have left.
Jesus, he sounds like a guy at the end of the bar muttering to no one about an old flame.
Genevieve, yeah, she was the one who got away. Genevieve, we met. We met in France alongside the River Seine. Should have never left Genevieve. I called her Jen, and instead of Donald, she called me.
Donald Trump Jr. Donald Trump, Donald J. Trump.
But you know, it was with a French accent, so it was cute. Donald.
And when Trump isn't depressed, his allies are whining about Kamala Harris going on SNL.
Even yesterday, Kamala Harris was apparently on an airplane headed to Michigan. They called her, do you want to be on Saturday Night Live? And then, you know, did a U-turn and went to Saturday Night Live, by the way, in violation of the law. But my only hope was, I hope she laughed on Saturday Night Live in front of millions of people just for her laughing for a few minutes, because that's probably worth 2 to 3 million votes right there.
What should be the ramification here?
Yeah, we need to keep every single remedy on the table. I mean, one of the remedies the FCC has ultimately would be license revocation if we find that it's egregious, and we'll see what they have to say about this.
You want to revoke NBC's broadcast license? Well, joke's on you. NBC doesn't have a license. It expired in 2005, and we forgot to fill out the paperwork for a new one. So for the last 19 years, we've been broadcasting illegally from the back of a Sprinter van that just circles Times Square. That was a pothole. Also, no, our windows aren't tinted. Also, Marco Rubio, that's how you think it works? Lauren calls a presidential candidate a few hours before the show and they make their plane do a U-turn? That, I would believe, is a violation of the law, aviation law. What's that? SNL? We'll be right there. This is how they are choosing to end their campaign. Unhinged allegations of cheating, whining about comedy shows, floating plans to ban vaccines, and threatening to retaliate against enemies, outlaw polls, and penalize speech they don't like. Trump is not being subtle about the threat he poses. He's dangerous. He's even starting to look like a traffic sign that says, road closed ahead. Kamala Harris is by no means a perfect candidate. There are certainly things I would change about her campaign if I could, but there are also things I like. Her plans to cap prescription drug costs, provide money to families of newborns, and tackle corporate price gouging. Her plans to build more affordable housing and expand the child tax credit. Her proposal to expand Medicare to cover in-home elder care. Those could all be transformative. And all the Republicans can say about her is they don't like her laugh, which, side note, is rich coming from the party of this.
I mean, what?
He sounds like a Tickle Me Elmo on his third rail of cocaine. Can I tell you guys something? Can I tell you guys something? I can't even feel the tickles anymore. I can't even feel them. So that's the choice Republicans want to present to you. That's their closing message. Are you gonna vote for a woman whose laugh they don't like? Or are you gonna vote for a guy who fomented a violent coup attempt after a months-long campaign to overturn the 2020 election, undercut the nation's response to a deadly pandemic that spiraled out of control because he tried to cover it up, lied about its severity, promoted sham treatments for it, said we could cure it by injecting disinfectant and shining powerful lights inside the body, and became the first president since Herbert Hoover to oversee a net job loss, couldn't figure out how to close an umbrella, cosplayed as a sanitation worker, even though he almost fell while getting into the truck, and pretended to work at McDonald's, even though he couldn't remember what the fryer was called, laughed about firing striking workers with the richest man alive, bragged about refusing to pay overtime, and said, I don't want a poor person running the economy, oversaw an increase in corporate profits while manufacturing jobs declined, presided over an unprecedented spike in crime while home prices rose by 30%, the national debt rose by $8 trillion, and the number of Americans without health insurance rose by 3 million, tried to rip healthcare away from over 20 million Americans, but reassured everyone by saying he had concepts of a plan, told a story about the size of a dead golfer's penis, regaled Boy Scouts with stories of sexy yacht parties, humped the American flag not once but multiple times, told women he would protect them whether they liked it or not, and would put a man who was investigated for cutting the head off a whale with a chainsaw in charge of vaccines and women's health, insulted service members, feuded with Gold Star families, and violated federal law by staging a campaign event at a hallowed military cemetery, doctored a weather map with a Sharpie to lie about the path of a hurricane, threw paper towels at hurricane victims, hosted a speaker at a rally who called Puerto Rico a floating island of garbage, claimed windmills cause cancer and kill whales, said you have to flush toilets 15 times, called Hannibal Lecter a lovely man. His national security advisor called him a dope. His secretary of state called him a moron. His chief of staff called him an idiot and a fascist who said nice things about Hitler and Hitler's generals. He suggested shooting protesters in the legs to his secretary of defense. He reportedly suggested executing rivals and staffers for leaking information. The former chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff called him a fascist to the core. He took millions from foreign officials, including a possible $10 million bribe from Egypt. His lawyers gave a press conference at a landscaping company. He lost the popular vote twice, got impeached twice, got indicted four times, and was found guilty of 34 felony counts, falsifying business records to pay hush money to a porn star. He asked a crowd whether they'd rather be electrocuted or eaten by a shark. He possibly farted and definitely fell asleep in court. Bragged about overturning Roe v. Wade, called himself the father of IVF while admitting he didn't know what IVF was. Called the CEO of Apple, Tim Apple, misspelled his wife's name and his own name, said Nikki Haley was the Speaker of the House on January 6th, claimed the price of bacon goes up because the wind doesn't blow, got on Air Force One with toilet paper stuck to his shoe, became the first president in history to stare directly at an eclipse, melted down in a presidential debate where he claimed migrants were eating dogs, spread lies about the federal government's response to a hurricane that caused FEMA workers to relocate due to threats, dances like he's punching a ghost, held a hate-filled rally at Madison Square Garden, stole classified documents, obstructed attempts to get him back, called climate change a hoax, proposed tariffs that economists say would increase prices and crater the economy, halted an equal pay rule for women, curtailed access to birth control, picked a running mate who mocked childless cat ladies, creeped out everyone when he tried to order donuts and was accused of having sex with a couch, which he did not do, even though he might have, but he didn't, but maybe he did. But he definitely did not. Said Kamala Harris happened to turn black, claimed his crowd on January 6th was bigger than Martin Luther King's Have a Dream speech, was banned from doing business in the state of New York for 3 years, and just recently posed for the single worst photo of any human being that has ever been taken on the face of the planet. So, you know, it's a toss-up. I've been talking about this man for nearly a decade now, as evidenced by the fact that everything I just listed is in my brain still somehow. The symptoms that gave rise to him will not immediately go away if he loses tomorrow, but we do have an opportunity to say, as a nation, that we want him to go away, and I really hope that happens, mainly so I never have to think about this ever again.
I had a girl.
This has been A Closer Look.
Hey, guys.